If you are alive today, you should be grateful to God. If you have life today, you should be grateful to God. But the question you have to ask yourself is, what is life all about? Is life about going to school, getting a profession, find some business to do, make some money, buy whatever you want to buy, marry if you want to marry, have some children, and continue till you die? Is that all life is about? If that's all life about, it's not worth living. There is a reason for living. There is a reason for life. And the earlier we find that reason, the better. You have heard about a savior called Jesus. Jesus divides men. It's just like the cross divides men. Jesus divides mankind into two parts, the saved ones and non-saved ones. The whole human race will be divided by Jesus. Unfortunately, the division will not be proportional. There will be more people who will be far away from Jesus than those who will be close to him. Watch as we walk through life. How many of us are connected to Jesus? The more people, once you are disconnected from Jesus in this life, you will be disconnected from him when he raises every human being back to life. We always tell you that the first death is not our choice. We die because some people made that choice for us. But God has warned us that there is a second death. And the second death, just like the first people, we have a choice to make. The word of God says in the book of Genesis, chapter 2, from verse 15 to 17, the word of God says, "And the Lord God took the man that he has made and put him into the garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it." God created the world and he created another domain called Eden. And in Eden, God also created a garden. Those of you who are theologically sound, it's just like the Holy of Holies. God, if you, the same shape as the temple, we have the altar call, we have the place of meeting for the general people, the priesthood, and then we have the Holy of Holies. So God picked the man that he has created and put him in a garden, and God commanded him, dress it and to keep it. And the Lord God commanded man, saying, "Of every tree of the garden you may eat freely, of every tree." God said, "I'm giving you more than enough. I'm giving you every tree in the garden, eat. But of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, you shall not eat it. For in the day that you shall eat thereof, you shall surely die." In this life, everything God said we shouldn't do, that's the thing men want to do. Unfortunately, the same choice that we're giving to the first people created in the garden that they disobeyed, we are facing the same choice. There are two trees in this life still. The same tree that confronted Adam and Eve in the garden, the tree of knowledge and evil, and tree of life. Jesus has been given to us as the tree of life, from which if you eat, you will live. Jesus is still the tree of life to today. In this world we live in, there is a tree of evil, of good and evil, and there is a tree of life called Jesus. But unfortunately, people are eating from the tree of knowledge and evil. Which one are you eating from? If you haven't gone to Jesus, you are eating from the tree of knowledge of evil and evil, and that will bring you death. Somebody, all truth is parallel. The same choice. The same choice that Adam and Eve faced and they failed, it has not changed. Today, this tree of life called Jesus. Jesus is the tree of life. Jesus is the tree of life. Unfortunately, he's still with us in this world. But you are eating from the tree of knowledge of evil. You are ignoring this tree of life, and that will cost you dearly. My listener, I don't know where you are listening from, but all truth is parallel. Even those of us in the church, there are many things about the Bible we still don't understand because we don't pay attention to read the scriptures and find out why Jesus became man. It has always been God's pleasure that the earth and the heavens unite together. So even in the Lord's Prayer, Jesus said, when you pray, say, "Our Father, who is in heaven, hallowed be your name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is done in heaven." God wants his will to be done on this earth, just as it is in heaven, and that is what will remain. It doesn't matter what the politicians say. They can corrupt themselves, they will die. They will perish in their sins. They can give you go ahead. They will tell you live the way you want to live. Essential life. Essentialism means nobody tells nobody what how to live. If I feel like I should have sex with a rock, I will do. If I feel like, as for me, I'm attracted to animal, that's what I would do. Nobody should tell me no nothing. That's essential living. That means we have been reduced from human race, from human level to animal's level. There are rules and regulations. Man has been eating from the tree of knowledge and evil, and we have forsaken the tree of life. Today, the tree of life, which is Jesus, the bread of life. What you eat, you call bread, is not bread. What you eat. What you eat called bread, you make some sandwich and you eat, is not bread. The real bread is that which comes from heaven. For the bread of God is he who comes from heaven and gives life. The bread you eat from McDonald's, the bread you eat from where? Nando's. The bread you eat from Greg's, they don't give you life. Man shall not live by bread alone, by pano, by bodo. Man shall not live by bread alone. I don't know how you call it in your language. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Bless you. Man shall not live by food alone. Man, don't live by food alone. There is an aspect of you which is eternal. You have an eternal being inside of you. Don't feed your flesh alone. Your flesh will be eaten by maggots. When you pass away, maggot will feed on this flesh. There is an aspect of you. It's called your soul, your nephesh. The Greek word will say nephesh. Your soul, there is an aspect of you which is eternal. God has put eternity in you. Oh, I love the psalmist. The psalmist said, God has put eternity in our hearts. Everybody wants to live forever. That's why some people go to the gym. We all want to prolong our life, but for how long? there is eternity in everybody's life. In your heart, there is eternity. But you will live eternal. Everybody, you will live eternal, whether you like it or not. You will live forever. But where are you spending eternity? Your long holiday, your longest holiday in life, where are you spending it? Are you spending it in Barbados? No. Your long awaited holiday, it will not be in Spain. It will not be in, name it, any island. Your long eternity holiday will either be spent with God or it will be spent in the blazing lake of fire. This is why we are here. Ecclesiastes says, remember that the dark days in the grave will be longer. If you live 100 years, I'm concerned. Today, you are eating from a tree. But what tree are you eating from? Jesus said, I am the bread of life. I am the vine. I'm the true vine. I don't know what wine you have been drinking. You have been drinking vodka. Sad. You have been drinking Budweiser. What is the name? Jack Dennis. You have been drinking from the bottle of somebody. What wine are you drinking? Jesus said, I am life eternal. Man shall not live by food alone. How many times have you eaten food today? Every one of you have eaten, except those who are fasting. Have you eaten the fruit of life? Jesus. Jesus warned them, don't eat from this tree. Eat from that tree. If you eat from that tree, you will die. If you choose everything except Jesus, you will perish. We love you. We are not mean. Every day we are disclosing the truth of God to you in phases. If you have chosen not to eat from Jesus, the tree of life, you will perish. You will perish. We are warning you. You think you are smart. You are not smart. If you live and die without Jesus, you will be the most foolish person ever lived. Because when God warned Adam and Eve, there were no examples. They were the first people. They had no example. But now we have the example of Adam and Eve. We have the example of Noah's time when they refused to listen to the preacher. Then we have Sodom and Gomorrah. We have warnings. Three times. There are warnings in the Bible. Don't joke with your life. Man of God, thank you. Says, I don't like any time we are preaching the gospel. We are preaching the gospel before you come to do this. When the Muslims were blasting loud music on Tower Bridge, did you go there to stop them? Don't be hypocrites. This is a Christian country. You dare not stop any Christian from preaching. This is a Christian country. This is a Christian country. The Queen has declared this country a Christian country. We are warning you before it's too late. Man shall not live by food alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. This is what Jesus says.
I will call Jesus. Call the police. I call Jesus.
No police will come. When the police come, you see how friendly they will be. You don't worry. Call them. I love when you call the police. Hello. Call the police. Call the police. You will be shocked. You will be embarrassed when they come. Hallelujah. Preach. John chapter 5 verse 24. John 5, 24 to 39. You don't repent and turn to Jesus. Don't repent and turn to Jesus. Don't repent and turn to Jesus. You will cry from the pit of hell. You will say, God, I should have listened to that preacher at Barking. John chapter 5, verse 24 to 29. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that heareth my word and believe on him that sent me has everlasting life Jesus said, anyone that hears the preaching and you believe that Jesus is your savior, he came to save you and accept him, you will have eternal life and shall not come into condemnation. We will be condemned based on what we did with Jesus. What you did with Jesus will either send you on God's side or send you to condemnation. God is not condemning you. He has given us a choice. He has given us a tree of life. He said, eat from this tree and live. Eat from this tree and die. And we chose, just like Adam and Eve, not to eat from the tree of life. And that is death. You better hear me and hear me good. You need to hear the gospel. Not come and stop a preaching. This same gospel will be used to judge everybody.
Preach.
He who believes is not condemned. God is not condemning you. You are choosing the life of condemnation. Jesus said, for the Son of Man has not come to condemn the world. Jesus has not come to condemn. He has come to save. But you are the one stopping yourself from being saved. It is not the will of God that anybody should perish.
Preach it, sir.
We choose to perish. God has given everlasting life, eternal life, life without end. But the choice is yours. God has set the table. He has set the food. And it is up to you to eat. God has set the table. God has set the table. God has set the table. A banqueting table. He's calling for every one of you. Come and eat. He said, come and buy without money. Come and get milk, free milk. God said it is free. Salvation is free. But the choice is yours. God won't choose for you. He said, I set before you life and death. Life and death. You see how they are pushing, buzzing? They are ringing people's phone. They are calling your phone. They are bombarding you on the television. Come and get vaccine. God doesn't do that. God doesn't push nobody. God said, I've given you salvation out of this mess. This life we are living in is a mess. This planet Earth is a dying planet. God said this planet is dying with everything therein. But God has given us a way of escape. And this way of escape is Jesus. This way of escape is Jesus. You choose Jesus, you have life.
Amen.
You choose Jesus, you have life.
Amen.
You are against Jesus, you are in trouble.
Yes.
If you are against the gospel, you are kicking against the prick. You are kicking against the God who wants to save you. You die and see. You will come and tell me if that place is a soft part. If you are hearing this, God has given you a choice. God doesn't condemn you. God doesn't condemn nobody. He has provided way of salvation. This planet Earth, when you die, it's not over. When you die, it's not over. When you die, it is when you die without Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior, then you are in trouble. Hallelujah. For Jesus said, the hour is coming, and now is when the dead shall hear the voice of the Son of God. The dead, the voice of Jesus will follow you into the grave. Today you are not hearing. You think you are smart. Even if you die, the same voice will follow you into the grave, but it will not be appetizing over there. It will not be a good experience. This same voice of Jesus will follow you down the grave. It will bring you out of the grave, but you will be punished. Jesus said, it's better you hear him now. Don't leave it too late. You see, when the people mock at Noah, They mock at Noah. For over 50 years, Noah preached. Nobody listened. But when it started raining, when the rain started pouring and the grounds opened and the rains were on the earth, they begin knocking at the boat. They begin knocking at the ark. Noah, openness. Now we know it is true. It is foolishness. It is too late. They drown. And Jesus warned us. He said, remember Noah's time. And remember Lot. Lot's time, angels have come to save them. They have under 24 hours. Less than 24 hours to save themselves. You know what they do? The gay guys and the homosexual guys in the city said they will rape the angels. Angels that have come in the form of human beings, they said they will rape them. You see how corrupt they were. They think it's a joke. By daybreak, not a single person survived. The whole city was burned down. Pregnant women were burned. Children were burned. Animals. Nobody escaped. We are making the same mistake. And our generation will be the most foolish generation. Because we have evidence. We have evidence. History tells us what God has done in the past. And God is going to do it again. As long as you have been born into this life, you are not free. You are not. It's God or the devil. There is no in between. And if Jesus is not your Lord and personal Savior, read my lips. You are a child of the devil. If Jesus is not your Savior, you are property of Satan. And you go where the devil is. And the devil is already condemned. Please listen to somebody. Listen. As long as Jesus is not your Lord and personal Savior, you may be religious. You are Satan's property. So God, according to Acts chapter 26, God said, go into the world and preach the gospel to everyone. Turn them from the powers of Satan unto God. We have come to turn you from the powers of Satan unto God. Flee for your life. You are making a choice, but your choice will cost you dearly. You are making a choice, the decision is yours. Well, as for me, I'm just telling you the truth. You can choose to make, it's a choice you are making. God is not condemning you. You have chosen. You have chosen. You don't care. You don't give a toss about God. God is not upset. As for him, he's waiting in eternity. He will have the whole of eternity. You are the one who will be crying from lake of fire and asking God, give me a second chance. A second chance for what? Today that you are alive, this is the day. Let me read on. Hallelujah. This is Jesus still talking. He said, I say unto you, the hour is coming, and now is when the dead shall hear the voice of the Son of God, and they shall hear, and they that hear shall live. For as the Father has life in himself, so has he given to the Son to have life in himself, and has given him authority to execute judgment also. Because he is the Son of Man. Marvel not at this. For the hour is coming, in which all that are in the grave shall hear his voice, and shall come forth. They that have done good unto the resurrection of life, and they that have done evil unto the resurrection of damnation. Hello, there is no way of escape. Even if you die, the grave will cough you up. The grave. Oh, I love this. There will be no hiding place. As long as you have lived in this life, you have lived under this sun, there is no hiding place for nobody. It's either Jesus or the devil. There is no in between. Come on, check my move. Jesus or the devil. Come on. Jesus or the devil. There is no in between. There is no in between. It's Jesus or the devil. There is no in between. If Jesus is not your Lord and personal Savior, you are a child of the devil. And the devil is a curse. The devil is condemned. He's a condemned spirit. You will go where he is. And where the devil is, there is suffering. Listen, already look at what we are going through in this world. What we are going through over here cannot be compared to where you will go without Jesus. Where is the police? Hello? Oh, somebody listen. A day is coming, and everyone, and you know what, Jesus, there is no qualms about this. When Jesus said this, they were doubting. Who is this man that says everybody, those who have died in the grave will come out? You will come out. As long as you die without Jesus, whether you die with Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior or not, wherever you have been buried, you will come out. The grave will cough you out. You will be judged and condemned. And because Jesus is not the only reason why you will not go to God, because Jesus is not your Lord and personal Savior. Nobody should come and ask me, what about other religion? God is not confused. God said, I've given you the tree of life and tree of evil and good. You have chosen other ways apart from the ways of God. You will not go to God. You will not go to God. The scripture says, marvel not at this, for the hour is coming, a day is coming, a time is coming, in which all that are in the grave shall hear the voice of the Son of God. All those who have died, it doesn't matter whether you die 1,000 years, 2,000 years, 7,000 years, everybody that have died will hear Jesus's voice, and everybody will come alive, and you will be judged. Some to everlasting life and some to everlasting condemnation. You don't want to stand the judgment of God, do you? You don't want to. This is condemnation. This is condemnation. That God has sent us everlasting life in Jesus. And you have decided, I don't want it. I don't want it. I want to go to God my own way. Oh no, that's foolishness. If there is any other way to go to God, God would have provided. Hallelujah. You don't want to go to God. If you want to go to God, you will go the way He has provided. You don't want to go to God. You just want to be religious. You don't want to go to God. If you really want to go to God, you will go according to the path He has given. Hallelujah. You are not serious. You are not serious. All religions don't lead to God. All religions don't lead to God. Religions don't lead to God. It's only one person, the person of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thessalonians says, 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 8 to 9 says, He will punish those who do not know God and do not obey the gospel of our Lord Jesus. Do not obey the gospel of our Lord Jesus. They are the ones who will go with the devil. The devil will be punished. The devil will be punished with all his allies. If you don't receive Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior, you are a property of the devil. You are an ally of the devil. And the devil is already condemned. And all with him will be condemned. Please, turn to God through Jesus. Turn to God through Jesus and leave. Eat from the tree of life. There is still the tree of life with us, which is Jesus. The tree of life is still with us. The bread of life is still with us today. What are you eating? What kind of bread are you eating? From which pot are you eating? Are you still eating from the pots of the devil? Some of you are drinking from the poison from the pots of the devil. Some of you are injecting yourself with the pots of the devil. Some of you are smoking from the pots of the devil. You have chosen death instead of life. The second death is your choice. The first death is not your choice. The second death is eternal. There is no end. The first death, Jesus is standing between the first death and the second death. Jesus is standing between the first death and the second death. Check the movement. Between the first death and the second death. Jesus is saying, don't die the second time. Hello? If you are born once, you will die twice. If you are born once, you will die twice. If you are born once, you will die twice. The second death is everlasting. You will suffer everlasting. There is no end. You will suffer in a blazing lake of fire. And whosoever's name is not found in the book of life was tossed into the lake of fire. This is the second death. You will be tormented from ever and ever. Hello? I'm not speaking Latin. I'm not speaking Greek. I'm not speaking my language. I'm speaking English. English. I'm speaking the Queen's language. You understand? If you are born once, you will die twice. If you are born once, you will die twice. That's why Jesus said, you must be born again. You must be born the second time to enter into the kingdom of God. If you are born by your mother and your father, you will die twice. The second death is everlasting. You will be burning in a blazing lake of fire. No water, no love, nobody will kiss you. Nobody will hug you. There will be no rest over there. There is no rest in the grave. You are not smart. You are ignoring this like Adam did. The devil said, don't listen. God is cheating you. What is God? What? Why would God cheat you? This buffoon life, this awkward life, do we call this life? The earth we are living on is a curse. We are living on a cursed land. The earth is cursed. God said the ground will yield thistles. But God so loved you. How do we know God loves us? He sent Jesus to become man. Jesus became man. Jesus became man and died in our place. There is no greater love than this. The word of God says there is no greater love than this, that somebody would die on behalf of somebody. That's the greatest love, and that's what God demonstrated. God, my sister, God loves you so much. If you have not received Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior, don't go home today without it. Hello? Yeah, I'm talking to you. If Jesus is not I'm not scaring you. You'll be better off with Jesus. Come to my brother. He will speak to you. Don't go without this, okay? Come and see my brother. He will talk to you. A day is coming. A day is coming. And it won't be long, because we are reading the signs that all those who are in the grave and those who are alive. But the word of God says Jesus will be coming down with the voice of an archangel. The trumpet will be blown. The earth will come down and kiss the earth. And the angels of God will descend on the crowds like on stairs. And the dead in Christ shall rise. And those Christians who are walking among us, we don't respect. Their physical bodies will be changed, because this body doesn't go into the kingdom of God. This body was designed for the earth. And our mortal bodies will be changed, and we'll be caught up with them in the clouds. And we'll go with Jesus. Then for 7 years, this planet earth will see something that has never been before. Hallelujah. Today, you have chance to enter into the kingdom of God. The word of God says that after the rapture, those who will be left behind, they cannot survive. You can't. Just 7 years, but you will not survive. Listen. Pharaoh in Egypt. When God sent Moses to go and tell him, let my people go, Pharaoh said, who is Jehovah? I don't know this Jehovah. I won't let the people go. Jehovah won't do me anything. We have our own gods. We have Osiris. We have Ra. We have Pine. We have frog gods. We have Nile gods. You are them. God threw just some few plagues. None of the gods of Egypt was able to defend them. None of the gods. None of the gods were able to defend Egypt when God threw the plague. This world is going to see that was a dress rehearsal. Whatever happened to Egypt was a dress rehearsal. Hallelujah. The real one is coming. Ooh, I love this. I love this. The real one, the real one. You see, all we see in the Old Testament, they are dress rehearsals. If you like, come, I will explain to you. All the Old Testament stuff, they are dress rehearsals. The real stuff is here to come. Can you imagine? Can you imagine? God will send one angel. The angel will come to the earth and open the path of the earth. And Bible said a creature, some creatures will come out of the earth in the form of locusts. And they will punish human beings for 3-6 months. Ooh. You are talking about coronavirus. Coronavirus will be a chicken change. These creatures that will come, no atomic bomb. Atomic bomb won't kill them. Nothing. Listen, don't let the word fool you. We are warning you. You know, the Egyptian magicians, I love this. I love this. I love this. When Pharaoh was bragging, and God began to throw the plagues, he called the magicians. The magicians told him, he said, Pharaoh, we are sorry. As for this, we cannot do it. Only the gods. Pharaoh was watching, and every water in Egypt was turned to blood. A time is coming. 1/3 of every water body on the earth will turn to blood. 1/3 of the human race will die. 1/3 of plants will die. 1/3 of animals will die. 1/3 of the human race will be wiped away. Within 6 months, a time is coming when the church is taken away. Today you see us, you think we are funny. You see us, you think I'm also this religious. Don't worry. We are waiting for God to rapture us. And you will live with the devil. Some of you say you love the devil. Don't worry. Go ahead. You can be his secretary. We will be gone. The church will live in peace. We will be going and we will wave bye-bye to you. And the devil who you love will come and stay with you. 7 years. You will cry. You will cry. And funny enough, God said, death will run away. God will suspend death for 7 years. It will be wild. Today, God will suspend death for 7 years after Christians have been taken away from this world. Don't listen to us and continue to live in your truance. Continue to live in your sin and puff out. Continue to live, I don't care. Don't care. When Christians are taken away for 7 years, the devil will come and live with you on this planet Earth. You will see. You will see the nature of the devil. You will see. You will cry for Jesus, but there will be no Jesus. Bible said the world leaders will run into their bunkers and God will bury them in their bunkers. You will cry. You will cry for death. Death, come and kill me. Death will say, I'm on suspension. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm telling you some good stuff. My brothers, give us some song. I will tell you more. You better repent than coming to stop preachers. I rebuke this filthy spirit. Brothers, give your life to Jesus. You will be better off. If you haven't given your life to Jesus, it's not cool. Do it before it's too late. The Lord bless you.